What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace, Aleya, and today it's another Tip Trick Tuesday. Alright, so in today's Tip Trick Tuesday, I will be showing you a simple trick on how to do the double exposure effect in Adobe After Effects. We're going to see a few techniques on how to achieve this effect, and it's just an amazing result. And it's actually not that hard to create, but I chose After Effects in order to do this effect because After Effects allows you easier workflows to work with this kind of stuff. So without further ado, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and let's get started. All right, so before I start this tutorial, if you enjoy watching my videos, please give it a like and also subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And I also want to show you something new I got here from BenQ. How cool is that? It's actually a screen bar lamp that you attach on your monitor of your computer so you can easier read stuff while you're sitting at the computer. Like me, I'm always sitting at the computer and my lights are always coming in from different angles. So having one from top is actually a really nice thing to have. And also if you're working late at night and you just want to see your keyboard just a little bit better, this also helps doing that. Or if you want to just kind of have a little bit more light in your room, but So yeah, thank you BenQ. If you want to check it out, I will put a link in the description for yourself. Wow, this light is actually really amazing. The second I turned it on, I actually realized how dirty my office is, so I gotta clean that. All right, so before I start this tutorial, I just quickly want to tell you a little bit more about this light because it's actually really awesome. I also want to let you know that I didn't get paid to say this, and when I say something like this, it's because it's my own and true honest opinion. Companies contact me on a daily basis and I don't accept each and every sponsorship. The reason why is I don't want to sell you guys off. I don't want to sell you crap. I don't want to talk about something that I am not supporting. So I stand behind products that I'm talking about on this channel, and this light is actually really nice. It's, for one, it saves a lot of space. It makes your desk a lot cleaner because you don't have light standing around it. But it also has a very nice and diffused light. I have never seen as clear with this light than any other different light because they come in from different angles, too far, too close. And this is just right where it needs to be. It also has an auto dimming feature, which means that overnight it will lower its intensity. And it also has an auto temperature control, which means it will adjust the color to be as perfect as possible in any light condition. And you can also lower the temperature, for example, later at night, so you don't have any of those blue lights when you're about to sleep. And they say it's actually bad to look at a TV or a screen or a light with blue lights in it. And therefore, you also have like apps on the computer that you can install in order to change the color a little bit warmer, and therefore you will have a better night's sleep. Unfortunately, in our business, that's not always the case because we are working with colors, guys. And if you're working with colors, you can't have an app ruining the colors with a warmer tone. So anyway, this light has all these features in it. It doesn't have to do anything with colors because it's a light. But yeah, it's actually really interesting to write something down in the office. I'm like more than 10 hours a day sitting at an office right here. So I'm writing things down, I'm reading something, and usually it's a very, I always have these kind of terrible light conditions, so it's actually really nice. They send it over to me. I actually kept it in the box for quite some time because I was a little bit busy with things, but I was more than surprised when I took it out. I wasn't too enthusiastic about this product when they sent it to me, but actually using it, it's a pretty useful thing to have in the office. So anyway, I will stop talking about this light. I'm sorry for the people that are absolutely not interested in this, that I kept going about this, but it's just because it's my own opinion on this. And yeah, they didn't tell me anything to talk about it this long, or they just wanted to send me out, show it in a video, and that's it. So anyway, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and continue this awesome tutorial. Okay, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and what I want to do is import footage that I will also provide you guys, and you can download it for free with the link in the description. All right, so I have a link for this video file right here. It's my girlfriend who was acting, well, she was acting in a music clip I was directing, so a really cool shot that I wanted to experiment with using double exposure effects. And then I went to this website called video.pexels.com and found this video clip. Video.pexels.com is actually a free stock footage website, so I'm sharing this with you guys. You can find free stock footage and you can use it in your project. So that's pretty amazing because stock footage kind of costs a lot of money.
So in this case, you can find some free samples in there. It's not the biggest library, but it gets the job done. And what you want to do when you're looking for objects that you want to use in double exposure is the first scene has to be with a lot of contrast, which means the background should be white. And in your subject, it would be even better if you have like harder shadows and stuff like that. But having black parts, because these black parts are actually going to show your double exposure effect. And then in the pixels.video, in the pixels video, I have here a three line, which is really cool because you have a lot of detail in here. And we want some kind of silhouette, some kind of horizon to work with. You can also use like skylines from New York, for example, which is also really cool. And having a sky that is kind of blown out is also great because we can just convert this to a white sky. So what I will do is import my footage and drag it into a new composition. And the first thing that I'll do is kind of just quickly cut out my subject here. So we'll just do like this very quickly and then press F on the keyboard and like feather it for 250% and then pixels, and then we'll right click new and create a new solid layer and create with the color picker, click just on a color from the background and click OK and bring this below it. So right here we can see that we still have some mistakes. So what we'll do is go to our mask tool with our selection tool, kind of just tweak this a little bit better. Okay. So now what I want to do is create a new adjustment layer on top of everything. And this is going to be adjustments, and this is going to be background. And close everything down. No sound. Okay. And in the adjustment, we want to go for effect, color correction. And you can either go for a color double exposure effect or a tint effect to make it black and white, which is also pretty cool. And also we're going to apply levels to it here. So the levels, you see that right here we have these kind of histograms. And if we bring this one to the left, we'll have more black. So right here the black starts and then right here the white starts. So we'll just drag this over until we have white in the background. And then here we can play around with the contrast a little bit, something like that ought to do it. And then we're going for effect, color correction, and hue. I just want to shift the hue a little bit more towards red tones and just lower the saturation just a bit. So we have something like that. Maybe a little bit more contrast now. I don't know. It's completely up to you, of course. But to be 100% honest, I didn't kind of prepare the shot to become a double exposure effect, so therefore I didn't really shoot it 100% perfect. Like I could have worked a little bit more with harder lights and that would give me a better result in my opinion, but anyway, this will do a great job. So what we'll do now is go to our project file and import the pixels video on top of it. And actually, we'll select these three layers and just go to layer and pre-compose them into a new composition. So we have this, all separated. So footage, click OK. And then for the pixels video, we want to right click, transform and fit to the comp width. There we go. And then scale it up again. So we cover the entire area. And then again, I want to click on this one, layer, pre-compose this. And this is going to be our mat. And click OK. So we have a lot of ways on doing double exposure effect. Very simple, you can go toggle switches and just change this to a screen. And right there, you already have a nice double exposure effect, which is pretty cool. And maybe you can go and choose like a rectangle and then subtract it over here and feather it out over here. And then move it over until you're satisfied. And then you have this kind of quick double exposure effect, which works well. So blending modes is one of it. And as you can see right here, everything that's white doesn't get covered and everything that's dark does get covered the best. So that's why I'm saying having a lot of contrast is great, having things like that. So in the hair, we are having black colors and now you can go and change all the positioning and do your things this way. So that's the first technique, but I don't want to do that one for this technique because I want to go a little bit crazier. So what I'll do is open up my mat. And in here, I will do two things. First of all, I'm going to duplicate my video footage. So I'm going to click on my video file on my layer, hold Ctrl and press D on the keyboard to duplicate it. So now we have two copies of that video and I'm going to unselect that first one. So for the bottom one, I'm just going to simply click on it and go for effect color correction and apply a tint effect to it. So now we have a black and white version of it. Then for the other one on top, we're going to enable this and we're going for effect color correction colorama right here. And this will get your shot looking all kind of funky, but simply we go to the output cycle tab right here and change our user preset palette to ramp gray. And then in here we have the same kind of thing. It's going from white to black with some grays in between, which we don't want. We want white and only black. So we are going to click over here just on the side of the circle and make a black color and then click right over here and make this a white color. And now very simply just drag this all the way until we have everything black. Okay, perfect. So now one more thing we want to do is kind of remove all these white spots in the trees. So we're going to create a new solid layer and make this black and put it on top and just disable it for a second. And then take your pen tool, zoom out a little bit and just draw a nice mask like so. Then enable it again, and we're going to click on this layer, the solid, and our second video layer, and then layer pre-compose this. This is going to be our Luma matte. Okay, so now what we want to do is kind of fade it into each other. So we're going for effect, transition, linear wipe, and change it to like 35%, 180, and feather it to 350. And there we go. So now we have our detail becoming black. So it's actually that simple. Now if we go back to our footage, we want to rotate our tree. So W on the keyboard will enable you to rotate your footage. And now we have rotated footage. Then you want to click on the toggle switch modes until you see the track matte menu right here. And on your video footage, you want to click over here, Luma inverted matte. And there you have it. So one more thing you have to do is go into your footage. We have this background here. We want to copy that. So Control C, go back to the main composition and paste it and put your background on the bottom here. And actually, because we used an adjustment layer, we want to actually go to the adjustment layer and just copy these settings and paste them on the background. That will match it perfectly. And now for in the sky, we just want to do a few things. So right here in our matte, we want to make sure that the sky is kind of blown out. So we want to click on the pixels video, go to effect, color correction and curves. And with the curves adjustment, you can just click over here and just bring the highlights up. And there we have it. So if you go back to the main composition, that should get rid of it. Okay, so now we have a nice cutout using our footage. So that's super cool. Our matte is right here. We're going to click on it and we can now move it around. We can even scale it up to create a little bit more detail in there and kind of bring it up. You can also go in there in the matte and maybe play up with the percentage, maybe 50%, and go back and see what that does. So that's a little bit too much. So maybe 40%. And go back. And that way you'll see these kind of different options. I think 30 in this case will be a little bit better. And of course, what you can do is duplicate your matte in the project manager. So we have our matte right here, duplicate that. And if we bring this on top again, and actually we wanna click on our matte and duplicate it also right here. So Control D and enable it so we see it. Then click on our matte 2 and Alt. Hold Alt and drag it on top of the other mat, and that will replace this composition. If we go in this one, we can go back here and maybe disable the Luma mat and go over here and maybe disable the tint effect. And if we go back to the footage, we can change this blending mode to a screen, and we can also use this mat. So duplicate it, put it on top and use the mat 2 also as a inverted Luma mat or a regular Luma mat in this case. And that way you have some colors in there. So without the colors, and with the colors, it doesn't really do that much. But what we can do is duplicate the original mat one more time. It's not that hard. I hope you're still following. And clicking on this mat right here and alt drag it on top of that one. Jump in here. And maybe this time we want to offset our transition to something like 50%. And I think I click on the wrong layer. So go in mat 3. Okay, there we go. So that way you blend in a few of these colors more to the top. So that's also a really cool effect. And of course, you can go and play around with different videos and styles, and it's completely up to you. So basically, you experiment with the Luma mat as a cutout effect and the blending mode screen to get the original video come true. Well, to get the overlay video come true in the black tones of your image. So that's how it basically works. And you can also go for an effect adjustment layer, a new adjustment layer, and go for effect color correction tint. And that way you get a nice black and white contrasty video look, and maybe effect curves and bring down the contrast a little bit. And that way you get something artistic like this. Or we can delete the tint effect or keep it and go for effect color correction and tritone. And with tritone, you can also do some unique stuff. For the white, for example, we can go for a nice red color. And for this one also, let's go into the orange tones. Let's see what we can get. Something like this. And for the shadows, maybe something like a blue. And that way we get some kind of artistic kind of looks, in my opinion. It's looking pretty dope. How cool does that look? Wow. That's actually pretty artistic, if I say so myself. All right, so that's how you work with double exposure effects.
All right, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists, and also photographers. So anyone that is actually a digital creative. And if you buy something from our website, it really helps to support this channel.